Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Marika, and today I'm going to be doing a product review. So I got my first ever PR package in the mail yesterday from when I'm filming this. And it's from a brand called Unicorn Lashes. If you don't know who they are, you probably do because the lady who makes the brushes, she had a product, these unicorn brushes that went viral, and they were like really, really popular. If you don't know, I'll leave all of her information down in the description box, and I guarantee that if you know anything about makeup or follow makeup at all, you will know who she is. But today, I'm going to be reviewing a product that I kind of helped a little bit with, which I was so honored and super excited to get for free in the mail. And just so you know, just because I got it for free doesn't mean that I'm necessarily going to like it. I'm just really excited to get it. So, she designed these new unicorn brushes, which are called the Royale Collection. So let me show you what they look like. So that's the box. And then these are the brushes. This is the little unicorn that comes with it. But look at them, they're so pretty. Can we just talk about like this painting though? It's like, I love it. It's really pretty and I really love it. But these are the brushes, so it comes with a bunch of face brushes and then some eye brushes. Now, the card that I was talking about here, this card has all the information on what the brushes are called and what they're used for. So basically, I'm gonna use every single brush if I can, and I'm basically gonna tell you if I like them or not. Basically how it's gonna go, and yeah, so let's start this and let's see if these brushes are worth it. So first things first, before we get started, the brushes do come with this felt diamond shaped case that they all come in, so it's super pretty and really cool. And then even like this, I don't know if you can see it, but like even this is like a unicorn head, so that's like super cool. But yeah, so, just wanted to let you know, it does come with the case if you buy it. My dome-shaped foundation brush is suited for all foundation types. The big plus is the dome shape won't flatten out too much when buffing on one's face. It diffuses product rather than depositing it heavily. Taking my next Total Control Drop Foundation. So right off the bat, first thing I'm gonna say is there's a reason why I don't use brushes to apply my foundation. Now, not to say that I didn't like the brush, you definitely have to like stipple it, you can't smear it, I guess, for lack of a better word. To apply the foundation, you definitely have to bounce it because it's definitely streaky otherwise. But if you bounce it, it looks basically the same. That's the only thing I can think of, and it also feels really heavy on my skin. I don't know if it's because I applied maybe too much. I feel like it didn't apply it in like the same full coverage that I typically like and then what I typically get with my beauty blender. So I feel like I tried to make up for that by applying more foundation on top of it. So there's that. The handle is a good thickness. I thought maybe it would be too short or something. The only problem I can see there being is if you like to hold your makeup brushes closer to the end of the handle, it does like thin out. It doesn't stay the same thickness all the way through. So I can imagine it would get harder to hold. But yeah, so let's move on to contour.
Illustrate one's face with my definition face brush. Great for detailed facial contouring with powder, cream, or liquid. Unicorn tip. Great for buffing all those nooks and crannies around the eyes and nose area with concealer whilst being gentle simultaneously. girl needs to age gracefully.
I'm going to be using this for contour, so I'm going to take my e.l.f. powder contour quad, and I'm just going to dip into this cool toned contour and just carve out my face like I normally would. Once again, the brush is super soft. It's very dense. It's not to the point to where it's kind of like too dense. Personally, I think maybe it's a bit too small to be used for contour. I would probably use it to like spread out concealer and like maybe set my face and cut out like in like to help carve my contour, but not necessarily to like put my contour in. Not that it did a bad job or anything. I just think it's really small for what they're saying it should be used for. Not to say, obviously, you can use this for contouring your face. I just personally think it's too small for my face to be used for contour.
The king of fan brushes, this bad boy king will strobe highlight like a beam on one's face. Unicorn tip. With a powder contour on your brush, turn it to the side and flick or twist back and forth a few times. Hello, foolproof contour line.
Now, I already went and applied my brows, my concealer, and I'm currently baking my face right now off camera because the set does not come with any brushes that are supposed to be used for any of that sort of stuff. So I just went and did them off camera so that way I don't waste any time. So I'm gonna use this to apply my bronzer, and I'm just gonna get a little bit on the brush there. Oh, and you know what, you guys? So because of my asthma and stuff, my medicine makes it so I can't smell about 95% of the time. I don't have the ability to smell. So the other day I got a short whiff of smell, but I was able to smell this for the first time since getting it probably about 6 months ago. Oh my gosh. I've heard how amazing these smell, and I've never been able to smell them until now. It smells like heaven. Like, oh my goodness, it smells so good. I had no idea they smelled so good. But I just like sat there smelling it because it smelled so good. The happiest of pandas I was. All right, and now that I applied the bronzer, I'm just gonna use the brush and wipe away whatever excess powder there is. And I mean, it's pretty hard to mess up bronzer, so I mean, for this brush works perfectly. No complaints at all. Once again, super soft. In case you were thinking that maybe one of the brushes isn't going to be soft. So far, they've all been really soft. Use it as a fan. Anyways, on to the next brush.
This little queen is a multi-use powder brush, great for applying blush, bronzer, and highlighter with a dome-shaped flat head. Yes, it does it all. Unicorn tip. Used for precise application on areas like the apples of cheeks, it features a specially rounded brush head to work perfectly for this.
Alright, for blush, I'm using ColourPop's Super Shock Cheek and Cheerio. Now, the only downfall I can see to these brushes with blush, you literally can't see if there's any product on the brush. Alright, like I said, the only problem I can see with this brush is that you literally can't see if there's any product on it because it's the same color as any blush that you might use. Now, it did say that this brush can be used for highlighter, so I'm gonna use it for highlighter real quick just to see how it works. So I'm just gonna take my Moonchild palette here, just dip into Pink Heart. All right, did do a horrible job with the highlighter, but it's not as blinding as I would personally like it to be, so I probably won't use this for highlighter. I'll probably use this as my contour brush, honestly, because this is about the same size and shape as the other brush that I use for contour, so that's probably what I'm going to use it for.
Made so that the bristles aren't too soft and flexible, this brush is perfect for accurate blending for above and under one's eye. Unicorn tip, blend out the highlighter on your brow bone with this Royale brush.
So now that we've done all the face brushes, we're going to move on to the eyes and do the eye brushes. So I'm going to be taking this, which is a blending brush according to the package, and I'm going to be taking my Mani palette. And I'm going to take a frappe here. Now, one thing that I do have to say about this brush is that the handle is super short. Like, if you look, it's probably the same length as my hand here. I think it's actually shorter. It's like, the bristles are a weird density, like they're not too dense, but they're not like super fluffy either, which is what I'm used to for a blending brush. It still works as a blending brush. I'm not saying that it fails at its job. What I'm saying is it's almost like it's too dense for a blending brush. It still works, but it almost feels too dense. I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm used to like really fluffy blending brushes. I don't know. And then, like I said, like the handle was super short, so like I'm holding it and I have nothing left on the end of the brush to hold on to. And obviously it gets skinny again at the end of the brush versus the front of it. So this here is like flexible. I don't know if you can see that. I don't want to like break it, but so it's like weird because you don't want to apply too much pressure to the end of it while you're using it, but at the same time it's like you don't want to be holding it all the way up here.
Bullet shaped and great for smudging and adding depth into the crease or even under one's eye to smoke everything out further. Unicorn tip, use a dab and pack method with this brush. Dab in your shadow and pack in your crease.
Alright, and then I'm going to be taking Aphrodite here. Same problem with this one as with the first one. It's a weird density. It works perfectly for what it says, which is the crease, for deepening that crease line. It works perfectly for that, and it actually blends the shadows out really well too, which I'm pleasantly surprised about. But once again, handle is super short. I didn't know what to do with my hand because I didn't want to hold it too close to the end of the handle, but I also didn't want my hand like super close to my face. So love hate with how long this handle is on these brushes, man.
A dual purpose brush for packing on color or creating a smoky eye by blending color seamlessly. Dense but soft, it applies just the right amount along the upper lid and lash line.
Alright, just gonna take this and dip into Luna. Now, this brush works perfectly for what it's a perfect packing brush for getting that pigment or shimmer shadow right on your lid to create the perfect smoky eye. The handle length isn't really a problem with this one, only because of what it's being used for. For me, I personally hold it closer to the front when using packing brushes, so it's not really a problem for me in terms of like handle length. I'm actually gonna dip back into Aphrodite and use it to. I never needed gifts or diamond rings. All I ever need, I need, I. All I ever need is. So good for the lower lash line too.
My tear-shaped eye brush is designed for accentuating and blending the crease area with precision. Unicorn tip. Use this brush to apply a base crease color, then go in with a self-supreme brush to define and bring more intensity, finishing off with the rest in crease brush again to blend it all out.
Now, this is a blending brush as it says, so I'm just gonna use this to just really clean up any of the edges. Make sure everything's all perfectly blended. Oh, I can get enough. Perfect.
I love this brush for applying a shimmery pearl shadow into the tear duct. It's the one thing my look is never without, as I love big eyes. It's also awesome for detailed eye work and tidying up with concealer. Unicorn tip. Double up and use this brush for lining lips. It does a great job.
Alright, taking this color here. Move it on the brush. Listen to your heartbeat, don't you know? That I just wanna be with you. There is a place where we can... This is a perfect little inner corner highlight brush. It's the right size, it's the perfect density, it's not too flimsy to where you can't really like pack it on, but it's also not like too dense to where you're gonna like hurt yourself if you, like, it's like perfect for an inner corner highlight brush. Alright you guys, I went and finished the rest of my look off camera, so I guess I'll just give you my final thoughts on these gorgeous brushes. One, they're super pretty. So, I mean, if anything, even if I weren't going to use these, like any of these, they make a stunning decorative little thing. And heck, I would use this case, like, for the brushes that I already have. So the case definitely wouldn't be going to waste. This would be used constantly whenever I travel. Yeah, I mean, the only problem that I had was the density of with some of the eye brushes was a bit weird. So it was like, I didn't know what to think about them. It just could be because I'm not used to brushes that are that type of density. And then the handles are a bit short on the eye brushes. So that's another thing which is a bit kind of eh for me, but I mean, it's not something that I can't work with. I have small hands, so if you have even smaller hands than me, it shouldn't really be a problem for you, but if you have bigger hands, then I can definitely see it being a problem. I wouldn't, like, with just regular use. But yeah, I believe these brushes are still for sale. I don't recall how much they are. It'll be somewhere on the screen here. They are really great. They're soft. They do exactly what they're supposed to do perfectly fine. And if they don't do that okay, I guarantee you can find another way to use them, because they're pretty versatile shapes. So if you don't like how it does what the piece of paper says it's supposed to do, then I guarantee you, you can find another use for it. But if I hadn't been sent these, I definitely would have bought them. And knowing what I know about them now, I definitely would still buy them. I love them. Mel is an amazing woman. If you've never talked to her, she is great. I loved working with her on these. I kind of just helped her, point her in the right direction with what she was trying to go for and everything. So that's kind of why she sent me the brushes, as a thank you for helping her out when she was still in the designing process with all of these, and with this collection, I should say. But yeah, so thank you, Mel. Yeah, that is the sweetest thing anybody has ever done, and I couldn't be more ecstatic to have these brushes, so thank you so much. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you in the next one. All of Mel's information will be down in the description, so go show her some support. I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!